Hey, what's up, everybody? I hope you're all doing great out there today. This is my review of Shadow in the Cloud from director Roseanne Liang, starring Chloe Grace Moretz. This movie really does fit into a bunch of different genres. It's part time period war movie, part fantasy, part action, and it has some mild horror elements to it as well. So let's get into this movie to see if all of these tones actually fit together into an entertaining movie you should be adding to your watch list.
Strap in.
Yes, ma'am.
The story in this one is set during World War II. It follows a female pilot played by Moretz that's tasked with protecting this top secret package. She hitches a lift on this bomber plane. She's riding down in the gunner turret, and it isn't long before she and the crew realizes that in addition to foreign fleets of planes stalking them is something much more inhuman and sinister, something that's lurking around their aircraft in the shadows. Now, I'm never one to simply sit back and just bash a film, no matter how much it failed to entertain me. Overall, Shadow in the Cloud was not a particularly good movie, and to say it was ridiculous in places would be an understatement. It had a handful of flaws, but it also did have some positives, so let's get into those first, and I think you must start with the performance of Chloe Grace Moretz. I think she single-handedly makes this movie watchable. It's a wildly outrageous film in terms of the tones and the themes and how they're put together, but the effort from her performance translates nicely on screen to create a character that I think you can invest in where the story progression itself may fail to do so. I think Moretz brings a toughness to the role that I found to be appealing. She brought the physicality that was needed, and she delivered plenty of emotional intensity as well. I also enjoyed the direction from Liang. I thought it fit nicely with the styling of this time period noir atmosphere that the movie kind of had going on for it. I liked how she framed a lot of the shots to build intensity through little teases of this beast lurking in the shadows of this plane. I also think the lighting and the production design in places were a strong positive for me as well, as it kind of created a dated, hyper-realistic vibe similar to a film like, say, Sky Captain in the World of Tomorrow. And early on in this movie, it was effectively able to lure me in. Sadly though, those were really the only positives that I took away from this movie, which does lead into the drawbacks. And on that side of the film, I think the script is where the flaws in this one begin to take over and take center stage. The storyline was a bit messy. It resulted in many chuckle-worthy moments at the movie rather than with it. Like I said, it starts out surprisingly compelling, despite the over-embellished misogynistic dialogue undercutting the tension in places. You have this woman sort of sneaking her way onto the plane with a package of unknown contents. Once up in the air, they have to fend off fleets of foreign military, and then this angle of a creature crawling around outside and inside of the plane is tossed in, and it's a bit of a mashup, but for me at least, I was kind of getting intrigued by it. Unfortunately though, from there the story kind of falls apart. It gets way too over the top. It results in some absurd set pieces that defy all physics to the point that it's just a distraction. And as the plot begins to unravel the mystery of this package, I gotta say it only kind of disappointed me further, and that's where the interest really began to falter for me. It goes from a close quarter tension to big action spectacle to moments of horror themed violence with this creature, and it's all just layered with ridiculous musical choices that routinely don't fit the mood of the scene that the tunes are being played over. It goes full on serious and dramatic only to undercut it with awkward humor and many story situations that will evoke unintentional laughs. And I'll admit, sometimes I like these weird and eccentric movies that try to slap different things together to see what will work, but Shadow in the Cloud didn't really work for me. It's gonna get 50%. I think Moretz certainly does give her all, but her appealing character isn't enough to save a story that's really all over the place. The tone wasn't consistent. It results in kind of a choppy flow that in the end felt a bit like a bunch of different pieces of various movies kind of slapped together into a patchwork of reality and genres and tones. However, I gotta say, there is some mindless fun to be had in seeing Moretz fight a little creature with no hesitation. Now for today's My Silver Screen recommendations, we're going to go with a Chloe Grace Moretz theme today, as I have three of my favorite films from her resume. First, I selected Greta from 2018. It's a solid thriller, and her performance certainly does help carry it. Next, I of course had to pick Kick-Ass. It's a fun movie. I think she's awesome as Hit Girl. And finally, I picked The Equalizer. She isn't in this one as much, but she's a scene stealer when she is on screen, and she has a great chemistry with Denzel Washington. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, drop it a thumbs up. Leave a comment below. I'd love to talk movies with you guys. Share it with your friends. And without question, hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you can never miss a video. Here are some links to some recent reviews, just in case you missed them. All my social media links and the link to our official website are down in the description below. And I'll catch you next time.